I'm Dave Mars with Conservation Tips. You know, one good thing about a really harsh winter is that if we get a nice deep freeze, it helps kill a lot of the insects in the soil that might be eating your landscape, as well as a lot of mold that might be affecting your allergies. But the bad thing about it is that it may cause a pipe of yours to freeze, and if that's ever happened to you, you know what a mess it can be, and it can raise your cost tremendously. So today on Tips, we're going to give you some strategies and show you some products to help you keep that from happening in your home. Now, the first place that you want to look, of course, is where the water comes in, because if you have a leak anywhere in the house, you want to be able to turn that water off quick. So you might have to take a little while to look for yours, but it's a good idea. Most times it's right where the water meter is into the house, and that's where you'll find it. In this home, it's in a built-in like this, made it a little bit hard to find, but you know, you want to see this ugly pipe, so you build a closet around it. Now, you want to try this out without a leak going on. You know, twist it in, make sure that it's nice and tight, and it actually will shut the water off if you have an emergency. Now, going online from the main pipe coming in, we're going to find out what's going on with the rest of your plumbing. If you have kitchens and bathrooms on the outside wall, there's probably some plumbing in that area. So you want to police the area and see where your pipes are coming in, various appliances, and see if we have any penetrations of air. You can see daylight, perhaps, that might be coming in and causing a pipe to freeze. Now, there's many other ways that air can get into your basement through fissures around air conditioner lines, your gas line coming in, a hose bib, maybe there's some electrical outlets outside. All those need to be checked and see if you see any daylight around them, because air coming in through those ports can cause a pipe to freeze and cause you some damage. Now, once you've kind of policed the area to find some of the major fissures around the penetrations of this area here, it's called the rim joist, by the way, you want to take a little closer look at this area, because there might be some fissures that aren't quite, you know, visible to you, but that can really do you in. One that we find a common spot is between the foundation wall and this board here, which is called your sill plate. You can see right here, you can't see it from being down here, so you need to get on a ladder, check that out. And you can see a plumbing fixture right here. If there's air coming in, you're for sure going to have a freeze right there. So you need to get a variety of products to take care of this situation. We have, you know, good old standby caulking that'll take care of a small fissure. If it's a bit larger and you want to use some expandable foam, you know, of course that's available at your hardware store, as is something like this. This is like a spongy-like cord, and you can shove it into a pretty large gap. And then you can caulk over it too if you wish. So there's a lot of products there that will help take care of potential problems in an area like this. You know, now you can put some insulation around these pipes, you know, if you have a warm interior like this. This was here to keep the hot water hot to the appliance that it's connected to. But just to be sure we got no penetrations up here, it's very easy to go ahead and get your caulk gun. Get some caulk going up on that juncture. And this is the sill plate with your foundation wall. And just smooth it in with your finger. You know, hopefully no one's going to be judging your ability to caulk professionally at this juncture. Just get it in there and get it so it stopped any air. Now, if you have any fissures up in this area here where the rim joist is, you can go ahead and get some caulking in there too. And after you've done that, then it's a good idea to go ahead and stick some insulation to cover the rim joist. And you can buy small packets of insulation at the hardware store. And they fit nice up in there, and that'll help keep it warmer down here. Now, given that you're going to provide due diligence to sealing all the cracks around whatever penetration you might have on the exterior shell of the house, you still may be in a situation where there's nothing more you can do to stop that freezing occurring. So we're going to look toward maybe putting heat tape on your plumbing at that time. Now, there's a variety of heat tapes that are out there that have been perfected over the years that don't burn your house down. Of course, you've got to follow instructions when you put them in. Don't be like me sometimes where I don't need no instructions. You want to follow these instructions. Some of the heat tapes come in a predetermined length. So you might have to measure your pipes and see if you got the right amount of length there. And there are other ways to accommodate a longer pipe though. Say it doesn't quite fit the standard ones that are there. You can get into heat tapes that are cut to the length of the pipe that you need. You put the connectors on the ends and you can go with it that way. You can also go to a plumbing supply house. They have heat tapes that have been used for many, many years and they know to be safe. Now, you're probably invariably going to need an extension cord to run it to an outlet upstairs. So make sure you buy you know, a cord that's heavy enough to handle the amperage of this, so you don't have any problems with your extension cord either. Now, once you get your heat tape on, you're going to need to wrap it with some insulation. And this type here is the prescribed insulation that they want you to use. It's fiberglass with a vinyl covering, because we want the fiberglass to stay dry, and the vinyl will help do that. Now, you might want to wrap it a couple of times, actually, and add a little more, you know, insulation to that project. If you don't have a big job, like say you don't live in a mobile home where you know you need to have some heat tape on that pipe coming out of the ground, or say you have a washing machine or something in a room that maybe gets super cold because it wasn't quite insulated when it was first made, heat tape would be good. Or you might want to just use something as simple as a clamp light and have it down below the pipes. And normally the heat off of these, you know, unless the room gets super cold, will take care of any freezing potential that you might have in that area. If you haven't had a chance to go around and do this ceiling we're talking about, and a cold snap comes in, you're kind of worried about your pipes, then it's probably a good idea to go ahead and let some water trickle through your water lines. That way we have moving water, it's not going to freeze as readily as standing water. And it's going to cost you a little more on your water bill, but it could really save you one heck of a plumbing bill. And also, the one spot that can also help to get a little air into the warm air when you're upstairs, any cabinets that might be in the outside wall, you know, open them up. If you see any air, feeling air coming in there, we'll block that up too, but that can also be a spot where a little fissure, bad temperatures, busted pipe. The hose spigot is probably the most susceptible to freezing of any protuberance you're going to have out of your home. The water comes right up to the system here. If you've left a hose on, more than likely you've got water here, so be careful when the thaw occurs. You might get a leak right here. You may need to replace it with something like this, which is a freeze-proof spigot. The water is shut off back here. This pipe is empty, so it stays nice and warm. If that's not an option for you, you can buy an insulated cover like this for existing spigots. There's a little hook inside, hooks under the handle in there, and that'll keep it warm during the winter. Now, I know it looks as though the water is actually coming out where it should, but it's actually coming out a fissure that occurred when this particular plumbing piece broke. It had a freeze-proof valve down below here, which was fine, but if this would occur inside your wall, inside your house, you can imagine what kind of damage it would do. So try to do your ceiling, police the area, make sure you've got any cold air coming in where you don't want it, insulate, put some heat tape on, take care of the matter, because we don't want you to waste any money on a bad plumbing bill and a big leak. Dave Morris with Conservation Tips, and I'll see you next time.